King County is one of the most beautiful areas of the country. Its magnificent scenery, urban centers, and diverse economic base attracts people from all over the world.
Baskets are really very beautiful people out there.
In fact, according to the last census, King County grew by more than 500,000 people in the last 20 years. And our demographics are changing too. The Rainier Valley now has one of the most diverse zip codes in the entire country. In the Tukwila School District, more than 65 different languages are spoken.
So right now, we're very close to having nearly a majority of people under 18, people of color.
But despite King County's overall livability, living conditions are not the same. There are many inequities in our neighborhoods. According to King County's Equity and Social Justice Report, these inequities are having some very dramatic consequences.
We have some places in the county where people have the highest life expectancy in the world. And then we have other places that are just a bike ride away where people live 9 years less on average.
On Mercer Island, for example, the life expectancy is about 86 years. But in the south part of the county, life expectancy is just 77. The difference in life expectancy in our neighborhoods is mirrored by other inequities.
Where the people who whose health is not good, where the people who don't have a place to buy good food, where the schools are not as good, where the jobs are not as good and well-paying jobs, they're all superimposed on each other.
Disparity is a fact of life among large sectors of the population that lives within the inner city communities of Seattle.
Existing inequities make it very difficult for people to make choices. It means that they have to choose between being able to buy food, buying gas, paying for health care. Those are very tough choices for people, and it makes it very hard for them to get ahead and stay healthy.
48% of black kids drop out based on 2011 statistics. In the King County Jail today, close to 38% of everybody in the King County jail are African American males.
In a move to do its part to remedy these inequities, King County built a fair and just principle into its strategic plan and adopted an equity and social justice ordinance.
Considering social justice in everything we do at the county is a way that we can help secure our future, to ensure that we grow with the participation of every resident of Martin Luther King County.
Every policy consideration we make in this government, we will contemplate consciously the impact that these policies will have on the poor, the disadvantaged folks in our community, and try to figure out a way to be more accountable and responsive.
So one of the things that we've done in King County is really think about what are the conditions in our community that create opportunity for people, or if those conditions are lacking, really create barriers to opportunity for people. So these are things like safe housing, parks where people can recreate, get out, exercise, educational facilities, access to health care and different kinds of human services, transportation so people can get to and from jobs, grocery stores. There are some places in our county where people don't have access.
We've decided to incorporate a social justice and equity element into the plan that determines where transit will go, where the buses will run. So we're paying very close attention to where people live who don't have a car, who depend solely on the bus system to get to and from work. We're paying much closer attention to public health needs, where those populations live that don't have access to health care. And we're making sure that our clinics are situated in such a way that people can get to those public health clinics. We need more open space, trails, recreational opportunities for people that live in those impoverished neighborhoods. We know that the obesity levels are higher in those neighborhoods. And so in our next park levy, I think you'll see that we will be much more sensitive about investing into those communities where there are more inequities.
We're doing this to call attention to this issue in our region, a region that has some of the wealthiest people in the world. But we also have some of the poorest conditions.
But we can't do this alone. We need everyone pulling together, cities and school districts, businesses and nonprofits, individuals throughout Martin Luther King County. We can do this. Visit our website,